Mayor Solomons.
Mr. Chairman. Thank you, and I apologize for, I'm sorry for being late. I was stuck in traffic on Southfield. I don't know exactly all the discussion here, but I know that I've talked to Laura and worked with Laura closely, and I mostly just want to convey that I echo Laura's thoughts in terms of where we're at on this. While I certainly understand and respect the concerns, I think that the one thing that this board certainly knows, but we would convey to the audience, is that trust that, you know, we will build in parameters to make sure that it's continuous with the neighborhood and certainly not disruptive. But the reality of it is this site needs additional parking. It's a very, very congested site right now as it is. And I think that this is a good thing for the city of Taylor. The site in question was for sale for a long time. I don't think we had any calls or questions from anybody interested or prospectively interested in. So I know that the petitioner acquired it with hopes of doing exactly what is being proposed today. I don't know why they're not here. I don't know. I know that there is a tremendous amount of traffic and congestion right now. I can only hope that they show up at some point in time. But the fact of the matter is that while this may not be ideal for everybody, I think this is very much needed for the city of Taylor.
Thank you, Mayor Summers. Is there anything else from the board? I will go to the audience.
For my dad, 686-year-old Jackson, and I'm on the city council here. I'm new to the city council, so back in January, on January 3rd, we had a council meeting. It was my voice already. And we approved a waiver of items number 2 and 3 of the deed restrictions contained. I'm going to read what it says here. I don't miss anything. Contained in 2011 development agreement as attached between the city of Taylor and Brandon LLC on parcel, and you quoted the parcel number of Northeast 1/4 section 21 T3S R10E, city of Taylor, Wayne County, Michigan. Property is located at the southeast corner of Goddard and Purdy Roads, contingent upon the parking requirement being met. If not met, waiver will be null and void, and the original deed restrictions number 2 and 3 reinstated. At this point, when I voted yes on this to come to the Planning Commission, I thought it would come back to us. And Chair, you did say that after you've made a decision tonight, if you've made a decision, what does it that comes back to the council to vote no?
Whether we approve or disapprove, we send a recommendation to do one or the other to City Council. And at that point, City Council makes the final decision.
And your approval or disapproval is of the zoning? Is that what you're talking about?
That is correct.
And the zoning is where the house and the lot is? Is that the area where the parking lot
is? That is the area that is described in the proposal.
Okay, and those are both zoned what at this time? Just to refresh my memory.
Ms. Phil?
To the chair, it's dual zoned right now. The north 100 feet directly behind the commercial development is already zoned MT2, as is the property across the street on the other side of Lincoln. It's just the southern 100 feet that he's requesting the rezoning from R1B to MT2.
So if you're walking down that little aisle area there, what used to be Lincoln Street, that's now shut off. The house over here is MT2, and across from it is MT2, right? And then behind the house, going south behind the house, is what you're looking in to rezoning to MT2 also, is that a I'm understanding. Okay, so that's you're going to be talking and discussing yes or no tonight. Is that correct? Okay, and then after that happens, and like I said, I knew all this council stuff, so I'm asking questions. After that happens, then it comes to us as saying, yes, we approve of what you said, or no, we don't approve.
That is correct.
Okay, thank you very much.
You bet. Sir, your name, address?
Good evening, Honorable Chairman and Planning Commissioners. My name is James Tischler. I reside in Lansing, Michigan, 329 South Washington Square, Suite C is my office. I represent Mr. and Mrs. Jeremy Clark tonight, who own and reside at 22350 Avalon Avenue. This property is located within the notification boundary of, for this case. As such, they hold standing to comment in this hearing. This letter is their official statement to the Planning Commission, and they request it to be read into the record in its entirety. Review of the application material submitted for this case has identified flaws on both procedural and technical grounds serious enough to cause your reconsideration of its merits. In the following paragraphs, I shall present these issues for your attention and your consideration. Chapter 27, Section 27.02 of the City Zoning Regulations state the material and procedural requirements for a rezoning application. Among the items required in for applications is a traffic impact analysis, found at subsection B, sub 1, sub H. An inspection of all the items found in the case 18.04Z file finds no document nor any reference to a traffic impact analysis. Such a document should be conducted by a third party in accordance with authoritative methodology and standards, provide information on proposed traffic expected from the proposed development, and evaluate impact of the proposed development on roadways in the immediate proximity to the site. Section 27.02 clearly states a traffic impact analysis, as with all other subsectional items, shall accompany the petitioner's application. Furthermore, there is no provision for waiver of this requirement. The lack of this item means that at present, the petitioner's application is incomplete and cannot proceed to hearing. Therefore, I respectfully request your closure of tonight's public hearing and removal of this item from your agenda until all required items have been appropriately prepared and submitted by the petitioner and the planning department that determines the application complete for commencement of your review. Next, a further review of the application materials finds a flaw regarding consistency of the proposed zoning district with the City of Taylor master plan. Your consultant planner indicates the proposed zoning will conform to the master plan's future land use map via the Midtown Subarea Plan and its related overlay use map. Such analysis carries the following mistakes. Number one, the City of Taylor master plan does not present its base future land use map to a specific scale. However, under close inspection, it is possible to infer dimensions to the various use designation geographies. On this map, the demarcation between mixed-use and low-intensity residential is located on the north boundary line of the subject parcel. This means the subject parcel is designated low-intensity residential. Number two, the master plan's Midtown Subarea map appears to show a generalized area and proceeds to bisect multiple land parcels along its southern boundary in a distinct arbitrary approach. It is simply not possible to delineate which parcels are located within the subarea. Indeed, all parcels on Nettolong, both east and west of Cardi Road, are bisected. If this is your intent, it would mean all property owners on Nettolong, and in addition, Lincoln and McKinley Streets, are exposed to their own residential parcels being rezoned to MT commercial sometime in the near future. I do not believe this is intended by the city, given the master plan's strong emphasis on residential neighborhood preservation and rehabilitation. As such, your Midtown Subarea map is not a land use map, but purely a graphic to be used as advisory only and not for specific determination of the future land use. In a meeting with your planning director, multiple references were made to the Midtown Taylor Design Manual as basis to support rezoning of the subject parcel, and advice was made to review this document. I found two relevant items in review of this document, the Downtown Development Authority's Development Area Map and Proposed Corridor District Map. Beside the point that neither is a land use map, indeed, there is no land use map in the manual, my review finds that both maps distinctly establish their respective boundaries at the north line of the subject parcel, hence the parcel is not in the district. Taken together, these points conclude the only valid map for which the Planning Commission must use in this case is the base master plan future land use map. This map clearly designates the subject parcel as low intensity residential. Now, given this previous finding, it now follows that application of your section 27.04 criteria for official zoning map amendments immediately fails on evaluation under subsection A, subsection 1. The proposed designation of MT2 is inconsistent with the current City of Taylor master plan. In addition to your zoning regulations, consistency of zoning with plan designation is required by statute. Therefore, at this time, any recommendation by the planning commission or ordinance amendment by the city council in favor of the petitioner's application would immediately place the city in direct violation of its own zoning regulations and applicable state law. A remedy for this situation is straightforward. The City of Taylor must first or simultaneously amend the master plan, and specifically the future land use map pursuant to statutory, technical, and procedural requirements. I would submit such action may be an opportunity for the city to be specific in land parcel designations for the Midtown subarea. It is only upon conclusion of the latter that the amendment criteria in section 27.04 will be successfully met. So at this time, and in summary of this review, I respectfully request the planning commission remove case 18.04Z from its agenda. Thank you for taking time to hear my comments. And Mr. Chair, if you wish, I have copies of this letter which I distribute to the clerk and to commissioners if you desire.
Yes, if you would distribute the copies. Sir, there are other people here that do want to be heard as well. If you have anything more to say than this gentleman has said, please speak. Give us your name, your address, and tell us exactly. Sir, you come up here. Come forward. I'm sorry.